Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Last night on the News Hour, we debated Love Jihad Nailed. The response from you was overwhelming. Many claimed on Twitter and on Involve.in that this was rampant but never talked up. Others were shocked. Now, just to refresh your memory, Times Now raised the alarm back on the 23rd of June 2017 when India was jolted with what was happening in Kerala. Tonight, many new links emerge. As we take the entire Love Jihad investigation forward, we realize the horror that parents face, the shocking apathy of the state, and the diabolical plot to feed Hindu girls to Islamists in Syria and neighboring regions there. Part 3 of the investigation titled, and it's the hashtag tonight on the News Hour, Hindu Girls for ISIS.
A day after the Supreme Court order handing over the case of forced conversion and marriage of Hindu girls to NIA, Times Now has accessed chilling phone conversation recordings that highlight the plight of parents whose children have been lost to forced conversion.
മലപ്പുറം സത്യസരണി ഞാൻ നിന്ന സ്ഥലത്ത് വരാനാണ് പറഞ്ഞത്.
അവിടെ ഞാൻ വരില്ല, നീ കോഴിക്കോട് സ്റ്റാൻഡ് വാ, നീ അവിടെ അടുത്തല്ലേ.
അപ്പൊ ഒരു കാര്യം പറയാനാ, പോലീസ് സ്റ്റേഷനിൽ വാ ചായി, പോലീസ് സ്റ്റേഷനിൽ വന്നിട്ട് പോലീസിനെയും കൂട്ടി എന്നെ കാണാൻ വാ.
Hadia's father's plea in court led to the annulment of his daughter's marriage, with the High Court finding merit in allegations of love jihad.
ബന്ധ പരിവർത്തനമാണ്. അത് കുട്ടിയെ ഒറ്റയ്ക്ക് അവരുടെ കയ്യിൽ കസ്റ്റഡിയിൽ വെച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ചെയ്യുന്ന പണികളായിരുന്നു. സർ, മക്കളെ വളർത്തുമ്പോൾ നമ്മളുടെ കുടുംബ പശ്ചാത്തലങ്ങളും മറ്റും നമ്മൾ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്ന മതങ്ങളെല്ലാം ഉൾക്കൊള്ളിച്ചു വേണം കുട്ടികളെ എപ്പോഴും പഠിപ്പിക്കുക, എപ്പോഴും ഉപദേശിച്ചു കൊടുക്കേണ്ട മെയിൻ കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഇതൊക്കെയാണ്. അല്ല, ഇതിനകത്ത് നമ്മൾ കുറേ പുരോഗമന ചിന്ത ഇത് അതും ഇതൊന്നും കേട്ടിട്ടൊരു കാര്യമില്ല.
ഹാദിയ മേ ബി ബാക്ക് വിത്ത് എ ഫാമിലി, ബട്ട് ദ റിലേഷൻഷിപ്പ് ഈസ് കംപ്ലീറ്റ്ലി ബ്രോക്കൺ, as a mother narrates the ordeal she went through.
ഒന്നും അറിയില്ല എന്റെ പൊന്നു മകൾ എന്റെ കൂടെ. അമ്മ എനിക്ക് വൈക്കത്തമ്പലം കാണണം, അമ്മയെ വൈക്കത്തപ്പനെ കാണണം പറഞ്ഞിട്ടില്ല എന്റെ പൊന്നു മകളെ.
എന്ത് പറ്റിയതാ തോന്നുന്നു?
അവൾ ആദ്യം മതം മാറി. ഈ ജസീം പസി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ രണ്ട് കുട്ടികൾ, ഇവളെ നിരന്തരം അള്ളായാണ് ഏകദൈവം, ഹിന്ദുക്കൾക്ക് ഒത്തിരി ദൈവങ്ങളുണ്ട്, അതൊന്നും പ്രതിനിധികളാണ്. അമ്മ വൈക്കത്തപ്പനെ പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചിട്ട് പറഞ്ഞതാണ് ഇവിടെ വല്ലത് വല്ല നേട്ട ഉയർച്ചയുണ്ട്, അമ്മ നിരന്തരം അമ്പലത്തിൽ പോയി.
But it's not just about one family or girl. It's a recurring tale of betrayal and deception that has played out in many families across Kerala.
സാർ വന്നപ്പോൾ സാർ എന്നോട് ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി ആയിട്ട് സംസാരിച്ചു. അപ്പോൾ ഇങ്ങനെ സംസാരിക്കുന്ന ഇടയിൽ അപ്പോൾ ഇങ്ങനെ ഓരോ ISISന്റെ ന്യൂസൊക്കെ ഇങ്ങനെ പറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് TVയിലും എല്ലാറ്റിലും ഭയങ്കര ഫേമസ് ആയിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ എന്നീ നൗഫലിനെ ചേർത്തൊക്കെ ഇങ്ങനെ പറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ടേ ഇരിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്, ഞാൻ ലവ് ജിഹാദ് പോയതാണ്, അങ്ങനെ യമനിക്ക് പോയി ആടുമേക്കാൻ പോയി. സത്യം പറഞ്ഞാൽ എൻ്റെ മനസ്സിൽ ISIS എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ അങ്ങനെ ഒരു സംഭവം ഉണ്ടെന്ന് പോലും എനിക്ക് അറിയില്ലായിരുന്നു. പിന്നെ എൻ്റെ ഫ്രണ്ട്സ് വഴി ഇങ്ങനെ കേട്ടപ്പോൾ അവർ പറഞ്ഞത് എന്നോട് ISIS എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞിട്ട് ശരിക്കും മുസ്ലിംസ് അല്ല അത് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, അത് ശരിക്കും ജൂതന്മാരാണ്, അവിടുത്തെ ജൂതന്മാർ മുസ്ലിംസിനെ വെറുതെ തരം താഴ്ത്താൻ വേണ്ടി, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അവരാണ് ഈ പ്രവൃത്തികളൊക്കെ.
It was Times Now's report, first aired on June 23rd, that exposed the systematic and targeted efforts to lure and trap young Hindu women in Kerala.
We heard, overheard during that long durational phone calls that she was made to read the Quran. She was supposed to go to Syria, and in order to go to Syria, she has to learn Syrian language. She was intending to learn Syrian language, adopting the changes from Hinduism to another religion, namely conversion, which was a utter shock.
Times Now investigation has uncovered tapes that exposed conversion cradle, and as NIA begins probe, it's clear that the caliphate conversion plot has merit. Bureau report, Times Now.
one of the Love Jihad victims, Atira, has made a massive revelation wherein she has exposed the Zakir Naik connect to this entire plot. Atira, in a very stunning confession, claims that the hate preachings were used to brainwash girls, finally making them convert. And this is the entire angle of Zakir Naik. She says very clearly that vitriol that was being served by the likes of Zakir Naik was used to brainwash. She was introduced to Islam via this person's preachings, which majority of the community themselves abhor and say he is not a representative of Islam, but that is what is being used to brainwash these kids. The victim says she was influenced by him, and she says that I wanted to convert after listening to him. So in confinement for 2 months, when they were kept, these girls are being introduced to this kind of vitriol, the stuff that Zakir Naik spewed and preached. He was himself shunned, rejected by a large part of the community in this country, and he is the one whose preachings are being used. Listen to what this girl has to say.
ഞാൻ ശരിക്കും ഇസ്ലാമിലേക്ക് ആകർഷ്ടയാവാൻ കാരണം എൻ്റെ ഫ്രണ്ട് എനിക്ക് സാക്കിർ നായകിൻ്റെ സ്പീച്ച് കേൾപ്പിച്ച് തന്നിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അങ്ങനെയാണ് എനിക്ക് ഇസ്ലാമിലേക്ക് ഒന്നും കൂടി ഇസ്ലാമിനെ ഇഷ്ടപ്പെടാനും വിശ്വസിക്കാനും കാരണം. ഞാൻ ഒരുപാട് സാക്കിർ നായകിൻ്റെ സ്പീച്ച് കേട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്, ഒത്തിരി കേട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്, അതിൽ ഒരുപാട് ആകർഷ്ടമായിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഞാൻ നരകത്തിനെയൊക്കെ കുറിച്ച് കേട്ടിട്ട് ഒത്തിരി പേടിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. അപ്പം മെയിനായിട്ട് സാക്കിർ നായകിൻ്റെ സ്പീച്ച് കാരണമാണ് ഞാൻ ഇസ്ലാം എന്ന മതത്തിനെ ഒത്തിരി കൂടി ഇഷ്ടപ്പെടാനും അതിലേക്ക് പോകണമെന്ന് ഒന്ന് ഒത്തിരി ആഗ്രഹിച്ചതും അത് കാരണമാണ് സാക്കിർ നായികാണ് മെയിൻ കാരണം എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. പിന്നെ ഈ നൗഫലിനെ ഇങ്ങനെ നൗഫൽ ഒരു ദിവസം ഇങ്ങനെ ഓഫീസിക്ക് വന്ന് നൗഫലിനെ ഞാൻ അതിന് മുന്നേ കണ്ടിട്ടില്ല, ഫോണിലൂടെ സംസാരിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടെന്നല്ലാതെ നേരിട്ട് ഞാൻ നൗഫലിനെ കണ്ടിട്ടോ സംസാരിച്ചിട്ടോ അല്ല. അപ്പം അങ്ങനെ ഇരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു ദിവസം നൗഫൽ ഓഫീസിക്ക് വന്നു, DLS വന്നു. അപ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് ഒത്തിരി ബുക്ക്സ് കൊണ്ടാണ് വന്നിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നു, അതായത് തൗഹീദ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞൊരു ബുക്ക് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു, പിന്നെ ഇസ്ലാമിലെ സ്ത്രീകൾ, പിന്നെ പ്രവാചകൻ്റെ ജീവചരിത്രം, അങ്ങനെ ഒരു 10-15 ബുക്ക് ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കും എനിക്ക് നൗഫൽ കൊണ്ടുവന്ന് തന്നു. അപ്പം ഞാനത് എടുത്തു വെച്ചു. പിന്നെ നൗഫൽ അങ്ങനെ അധികം അങ്ങനെ ചെറുതായിട്ട് സംസാരിച്ചു, പിന്നെ തൗഫീഖിൻ്റെ അടുത്ത് പോയി. അങ്ങനെ അങ്ങനെയാണ് ഫസ്റ്റായിട്ട് ഞാൻ നൗഫലിനെ കാണുന്നത്. പിന്നെ ഞാൻ ഈ ബുക്ക് കൊണ്ട് ഈ വീട്ടിൽ ആരും കാണാതെ വായിക്കാൻ തുടങ്ങി. അപ്പോൾ എന്താ പറയുക, ഓരോ ദിവസം കൂടുമ്പോൾ ബുക്ക് വായിക്കുമ്പോൾ നമുക്കൊരു പേടി ഉണ്ടാവുമല്ലോ ഈ നരകത്തിനെ കുറിച്ചിട്ടും ഏകത്ത് ശിർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നതിനുള്ള പാപങ്ങളെ കുറിച്ചിട്ടും കാഫിറുകൾക്കുള്ള ശിക്ഷയെ കുറിച്ചിട്ടൊക്കെ കേൾക്കുമ്പോൾ ഒത്തിരി പേടി ഉണ്ടാവില്ല. അപ്പോൾ നമ്മുടെ അച്ഛനമ്മമാരൊക്കെ ഇതിൽ വിശ്വസിക്കാതിരിക്കുമല്ലേ, അപ്പോൾ അവരും ഇങ്ങനെ കാഫിറുകളായി മരിച്ചു പോകേണ്ടവരാണല്ലോ, അവരെങ്ങനെയെങ്കിലും ഇസ്ലാമിലേക്ക് കൊണ്ടുവരണം, അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ ഒരു മൈൻഡ് ആയിരുന്നു എനിക്ക്. അപ്പോൾ ആ ബുക്സൊക്കെ എന്നെ ഒത്തിരി ഇൻസ്പയർ ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്.
And there is more, ladies and gentlemen, which exposes their modus operandi. They were being used as sex slaves. They were being tricked to think that they will be sent to land like Syria and Yemen to rear goat, like the Prophet did himself. That was being told to them, or they will be sent for Hajj and Umrah. But the real fact and the real fact was they were going to be sent to the ISIS bases and camps there to be used as sex slaves. This was the reality. The young girls being solicited by men and women. Yes, that's another angle that emerges, which was talked about in 2009, but not done, not acted upon at all. Persistent talking down of the Hindu faith, then introduced to radical Islam, then use hate preachers like Zakir Naik and them to try and you further radicalize them and brainwash them. Then these girls were married off and then sent off to these camps. This is the shocking depravity, and one after the other, multiple cases where these guys come, the girls come, they solicit these impressionable young girls, brainwash them, take them to this one center or two centers in North Kerala, in Malappuram, and there they are confined. Their iCards are taken away, their phones are taken away, SIM cards are taken away. Two and a half months, 3 months, they are not allowed to communicate with anybody in the external world. And then they come out absolutely brainwashed. Look at the kind of things that are told to them. Listen to Atira again.
ഒരു ദിവസം നൗഫിൽ ഇങ്ങനെ വിളിച്ചപ്പോൾ എന്നോട് പറഞ്ഞു, നൗഫിൽ യമനിലൊക്കെ പോയി മതപഠനമൊക്കെ പഠിച്ചിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരാളാണ്. അപ്പോൾ നൗഫിൽ പറഞ്ഞു, യഥാർത്ഥ മതപഠനം ഉള്ളത് യമനിലാണ്, യമനിൽ പോയിട്ട് തന്നെ പഠിക്കണം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. അപ്പോൾ എനിക്കൊരു ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു, യമനിൽ പോകണം, മതം പഠിക്കണം എന്നുള്ളൊരാഗ്രഹം ഉണ്ട്. അതിനൊപ്പം ഇതിന് ഗൾഫ് പോകണം എന്നുള്ളൊരാഗ്രഹം കൂടെ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. മതപഠനം യഥാർത്ഥത്തിൽ അവിടെയാണ്, യഥാർത്ഥ വിശ്വാസികൾ യമനിലാണെന്നൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ, നബിയുടെ പാരമ്പര്യക്കാരൊക്കെ യമനിലുണ്ടെന്നൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് ഒത്തിരി ആഗ്രഹം യമന് പോകണം, അവിടുന്ന് മതപഠനം പഠിക്കണം, അവിടെ താമസിച്ച് പഠിക്കണം എന്നൊക്കെ ഒരു ആഗ്രഹം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അങ്ങനെ എന്താ, നൗഫിലാണ് എനിക്ക് പാസ്പോർട്ടിനുള്ള അപ്ലൈക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, നൗഫിലാണ്. അത് നൗഫിലെ എമർജൻസി പാസ്പോർട്ടിനാണ് അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്തത്. അതെനിക്ക് അറിയില്ലായിരുന്നു. ഒരു രണ്ടാഴ്ചക്കുള്ളിൽ തന്നെ പാസ്പോർട്ട് എനിക്ക് കിട്ടുകയും ചെയ്തു. അങ്ങനെ പാസ്പോർട്ട് എടുക്കാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് ഞാനും അച്ഛനും കൂടെയാണ് വെരിഫിക്കേഷൻസിനൊക്കെ പോണത്. അത് അച്ഛനോട് ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു കള്ളം പറഞ്ഞു, ഇങ്ങനെ ഓഫീസിൻ്റെ ആവശ്യത്തിനാണ് അങ്ങനെ കള്ളം പറഞ്ഞിട്ട്, അങ്ങനെ അച്ഛൻ്റെ കൂടെ പോയിട്ട് പാസ്പോർട്ടിൻ്റെ വെരിഫിക്കേഷനൊക്കെ കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് വരികയാണ് ചെയ്തത്. അപ്പോൾ മെയിനായിട്ട് എനിക്ക് യമന് പോകണം അങ്ങനെ ഒരു ആഗ്രഹം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. കാരണം അവിടെ മതപഠനം ഉണ്ട് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ യഥാർത്ഥത്തിൽ അവിടെയാണ് പഠിപ്പിക്കുന്നതെന്നൊരു വിശ്വാസമായിരുന്നു എനിക്ക്. പിന്നെ ഗൾഫ് പോകണം, ഹജ്ജും ഉംറയും ചെയ്യണം, അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ ഒരു ആഗ്രഹമായിരുന്നു. അതിൻ്റെ പുറത്താണ് പാസ്പോർട്ട് എടുത്തത്.
Viewers are writing in already on involve.in. Most of them are shocked at the revelations. A lot of them from the south of India, a lot of them watching from across the world who understand Malayalam are further shocked because the emotion and the facts, the way they come out in the native language, don't come when we put them out in terms of the translations in English. But the intent is very clear to our panelists, Dr. Sambit Patra, Ratan Sharda, Zafar Sareshwala, Rajiv Rai, Sayeda Shah Atif Ali Qadri, Mufti Ziai and Shahryar Khan. Good evening, Mufti Ziai with me here in the studio. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I have another document. This is what was submitted to the courts back in 2009. November 2009, a DGP in Kerala deposed before the Kerala High Court. And please listen very carefully as I open up the debate to what he said. I'm going to read three passages. Please read, see this. It says, one report talks about, 3 out of 18 reports talk about, 1 out of 18 reports mentions religious conversion centers in Kozhikode city. 3 out of 18 reports provide some details. One report says, functioning of an organization called Smart Front in 2 colleges. Now look at what the modus operandi is, and then let's link it to what we are exposing tonight on the News Hour and we have been talking about over the last 2-3 days, also since June. Fundamental outfits like NDF, PFI, Campus Fronts has roots in these college campuses. It is referring to Campus Front, it is stated in the report. As per the available information, the plan of this organization is to trap brilliant upper caste Hindu and Christian girls from well-to-do family, especially those who are studying for professional courses and employed in IT sectors. This is a Kerala DGP deposing to the Kerala High Court in 2009. Then he says, it is believed that a Muslim organization like Muslim Youth Forum, the Muslim women's organization like Tasreen Millat, Shaheen Force, Popular Front of India, National Democratic Fund and its student organizations like Campus Front are the organizations behind the so-called Love Jihad movement. Then, look at this. Last out of the 18 reports contains the following details. There is no information of any organization under the name and style Love Jihad or Romeo Jihad functioning in Kerala. However, the students' wing of NDF and PFI, known as Campus Front, known to be promoting religious conversion in educational institutions and professional colleges. This report also mentions the involvement of Muslim Youth Forum, Shaheen Force, etc. in these activities. Certain organizations in Saudi Arabia are providing financial assistance to these activities under the head scholarship to the youth. As per one statistics, I'm reading this further, during conversions after love affairs have taken place, another statistics it says 2,800 girls were thus converted into another religion. In 2009, a DGP is deposing before the court, are conversions after love affairs have taken place. In Kasaragod, Kannur, Kozhikode and Malappuram districts, 1,600 incidents of such conversions have taken place. Zafar Sareshwala, Let me start with you, sir. Why was nothing done about this? Because this is dangerous, especially after we have Anand, had instances of 22
better
people.
Better late than never. Better late than never. Anand, I'll just make a quick point. Now, when the Supreme Court is seized with the matter, I don't think anybody should doubt the credentials of the Supreme Court of India. Supreme Court has done wonderful thing, as it was the judgment itself says, that they've asked NIA to get into the detail of it. And not only that, they have also interested a retired judge of Supreme Court. So I don't think people should cast aspersions on NIA. I think NIA, the National Investigating Agency, is the premier terrorist investigating agency of the country. And if whatever report comes out, and now the Kerala government also has said that, okay, if NIA is doing the investigation, they have no problem. So I think now when Supreme Court has intervened, Supreme Court has asked NIA, they have given a judge to support them. I think, and absolutely, I totally, and you know, I have been on your channel, I have always opposed any form of conversion. Forget about forced conversion, even inducement. I mean, if somebody reads Quran, the life of the Prophet, then he or she may embrace Islam, that is between her and the God or yes. him. But anybody, and I am wondering, these preachers, I mean, are they preachers or business people? Preachers don't do all this. They just talk about love,
Mr. Anand,
coexistence of communities. This conversion, I don't know, it's never part of it. And conversion was never part of our ethos.
Now let me tell you.
Yes.
Just give me 30 seconds.
Sayyid Qadri. Forced conversion.
Sayyid Qadri, please. Zafar Sareshwala just wanted to make
just,
one point.
Just give me 30
and then
seconds.
We'll open it up.
30 seconds.
Okay. 1 point.
I have problem with this word love jihad. Because jihad is such a Puritan word.
Yes.
It is mentioned in Quran 41 times, Anand.
Yes.
And every single time, the connotation is struggle to be good. I can't imagine jihad word being used for falsifying, for fraud, or for these kind of activities. Jihad is a great word. It's a struggle.
I agree, sir.
It's an effort to be good.
I agree with you, sir.
And I don't
agree
know
with you.
How these people are using this
no, I agree
word.
With you because
it is the most misused
jihad
word.
I agree with you. Jihad is a sacred word. And if you were to go with the pure version and the format of it or the way it is supposed to be interpreted. But Justice Shankaran in 2009 refused to stop the use of the term love jihad. And that is the reason why, because of the findings that they came out to do, and what this entire movement was being called by those people who are practicing it, those people who are using this method. This all came from there, and the connotation came from there. And in that case, the Kerala High Court even went as far as telling the state government, form an anti-forced conversion law, form a law. They even went on to say, the responsibility of the state government to stop forced conversions and ask them to enact a law to protect victims of forced conversions. Nothing happened. Now, Sayyid Qadri, go ahead, please.
Jihad, let me tell you, Mr. Anand.
Yes, Sayyid Qadri, go ahead, please.
Yeah, I'm telling you, main ye bata raha hun ki that difference between jihad and fasad. Okay, the fasad is what is being done by the ISIS or the Lashkar-e-Taiba or the Gorakshak. All these kind of people are brothers. वो एक दूसरे के भाई हैं ये गोरक्षक हैं या आईएसआईएस हैं या आपके लश्कर-ए-तैयबा हैं ये सब एक दूसरे के भाई हैं अब मैं जो समझता हूँ, एंड नाउ द थिंग इज दिस, दे आर क्रिएटिंग फसाद इन आवर कंट्री, इन आवर ब्यूटीफुल वर्ल्ड, एंड व्हाट इज कॉल्ड जिहाद, जिहाद मीन्स के आप अपने बुराई के खिलाफ, आप अपने गंदगी के खिलाफ जिहाद करें। जो जिहाद का जिक्र कुरान में है,
वो तो आप जिहाद का मतलब मुझे नहीं समझाएं। जिहाद का मतलब मैंने भी पढ़ा है, मैंने भी समझा है, लेकिन ये जो कर रहे हैं इसको लव जिहाद इसीलिए कहा जा रहा है क्योंकि इसको यही इसी टर्म से वो लोग अप्रोच करते हैं। नहीं, अब आप बताइए कि 2009 में अगर ये बात उठी थी, सो व्हाट हैज बीन डन सिंस 2009? व्हाट हैज बीन डन सिंस 2009? सर, द नंबर्स दैट स्टैक अप डे आफ्टर डे, there are between 2006 until date, sir, 7,773. Let's put out those hard numbers if we can as we open it up to our other panelists. Ratan Sharda, good evening. Please come into the debate. After that, Shariar and also Mufti Ziai and Sambit Patra. Yes. Yes, Ratan Sharda ji.
I'll just make Anand, a few quick points. First of all, people are protesting against the misuse of jihad.
Responsibility of not acting on 2009 should be fixed. I don't think they have ever spoken against ISIS
and the terror organizations. Sir, I was supposed to talk. Now, who is this?
That was Zafar Sareshwala making a small point. Yes, go ahead. Go ahead, Ratan Sharda.
Because the Holy Quran says killing an innocent man.
I said jihad may be a pure word, but who has distorted it? Their own terrorists who have disabused the word, and have they ever had the courage to tell them to stop using it? That is, so just stop that point. I am coming to another very important point. Mallapuram history comes from Khilafat movement, when there was huge violence against Hindus in Mallapuram from 1919 onwards. It's a cradle of extreme Islamism for that time. It's a place, the only declared Muslim district by a Communist Party government of that time. It is a place where a father of the Malayalam language, Athusan, was never, the statue of his was never allowed to be unveiled. It's a hardcore Islamist district, Mr. Anand, where the government refuses to look in. And the worst part is, as a strange spectacle of extreme atheist like Marxist covering up for jihadi forces of Kerala. So this dangerous concoction of the extreme left with the extreme right is what is killing Kerala and creating a specter of so-called love jihad, which is actually converted into conversion to jihad of ISIS. So what are people doing by continuously living in a denial mode? By its sanctimonious telling us it's a good word, etc., doesn't anyway take away the problem that Kerala and India is facing because of the extreme elements being supported by these parties. Remember, Abdul Malani, head of PFI, the extreme organization, was felicitated, was given bail with support of all the parties, right from Congress to Muslim League to Marxist Communist Party. So they have, how can they talk against these people? Because they are the ones who encourage the extreme elements.
Yes.
They have supported the elements. So here we have a dangerous situation where political parties from the spectrum support a man who is head of extremist organizations called PFI.
No, and this PFI connect.
So let us not create.
If he can put out,
nice,
if he can put out the PFI,
is the truth.
If he can put out the PFI connect, and I tell you, sir,
this we are supporting jihadi.
No, this person, this SDPI is the political wing of the Popular Front of India. They're all these people, even the other case of Hadia, from which this case emerged, Sambit Patra. They are also all these people are members of PFI. All these people have got criminal cases against them. This person, Nofal, this girl, Atira, who just spoke right now, who revealed the Zakir Naik connection, who revealed the influence of Zakir Naik's teachings, who revealed the fact that she was about to be sent to Yemen. The other girl, Hadia, who's currently fighting, whose parents are desperate to get their daughter back, and they still can't get her back. And the other girls, they all have mentioned people who are connected to PFI. This man, Shafin Jahan, let's put out the details of Shafin Jahan also, if we can. Shafin Jahan is a history cheater. Ye banda claim karta hai ki wo dusri ladki jo hai, Hadia, usne shadi ki December 2016 mein. The courts declared it a sham. Ab aap ek baat bataiye. When the case was on, she wasn't married. Then they denied so that they can twist the facts of the case and claim that it's the right of the husband as a Muslim individual who has right over the wife, and try and supersede the rights of the father on his daughter, they enacted that marriage. That's what the courts deem, saying that it's a sham marriage. And I'm reading from the court's judgment of May 2016. Now, who is Shafin Jahan? He is closely linked to Buraki, who was arrested by the NIA in 2016. Buraki is an active member of the SDPI, and he was part of the same WhatsApp group called Tanal, of which Shafin Jahan is the administrator. Now, Buraki has an ISIS connection. Buraki is an ISIS connection. Their whole idea, imagine this girl, this girl Hadia was told that you will go to Syria to rear sheep.
Muslim women.
आप भेड़ बकरी चलाने के लिए आपको भेजा जाएगा वहां सीरिया इन 2015-16. कैन यू बिलीव इट संबित पात्रा डॉक्टर पात्रा दिस इज द लेवल टू विच दे वर ब्रेन वॉश एंड दीज वर लाइक आई सेड रीड व्हाट द 2009 डिपोजिशन बाय द डीजीपी सेज देयर आइडिया इज टू टारगेट द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज टू ट्रैप ब्रिलियंट अपर कास्ट हिंदू एंड क्रिस्टियन गर्ल्स फ्रॉम वेंटिल टू फैमिली especially those studying for professional courses and employed in the IT sector.
See, Anand, yesterday in the Supreme Court, when the whole issue came up for hearing, three very important phrases were used, and I would like to reiterate those phrases. Phrase number one, which was used by the NIA and the Supreme Court accepted it, was that there is a pattern to conversion. So naturally, this pattern to conversion has been taking place since yesteryears. Secondly, the Supreme Court used this connotation, this phrase, wider ramification, saying that this is not just a one-off a case or a standalone case. There is a wide ramification. So naturally, this has to be investigated. Thirdly, and extremely important, the Supreme Court said that we want the NIA to investigate this whole case because we want a neutral and an unbiased investigation, meaning tangentially thus, that if the investigation would have been carried out by the Kerala administration and the Kerala police in particular, then it would not have been neutral and it would not have been unbiased. That means the Kerala administration has been castigated by saying that it has influence over the Kerala police and wants a biased report in this case. Secondly, and extremely importantly, I mean, in this run for secularism and in this run for political correctness, most of the Indian politicians, in fact, have jeopardized the national security. Why do I say jeopardize the national security? Because remember, only recently, 21 of these youngsters in Kerala had been converted. Zakir Naik's name also had cropped up, and through various other means, they had been converted and they have been shipped off to Syria. And we had this Yahya's diary, if you remember, Indian Express had come out with the diary of a person who had been converted in Kerala, who worked in Syria, and who was so-called, quote-unquote, martyred in Syria while working for the ISIS. So naturally, this is a very serious national security issue. As far as the deposition by the DGP in 2009 is concerned, why the deposition way back in 2009? Only recently, the recent most DGP who retired, T.P. Shenkumar, he had come out and he has given an interview saying that this conversions and love jihad is a reality which the politicians of the present time are closing their eyes to. Two very important politicians, not from the right wing, remember from the left wing. One, Mr. V.S. Achyutanandan, way back in 2010, said that yes, there is a pattern in conversion and marriage patterns to an extent that Kerala's demography would be compromised after a few years. Then we had Mr. Oman Chandy, who was the then chief minister. 25 June 2012, he submitted a data on the floor of the Assembly of Kerala saying that this is the way conversion has taken place. Approximately 2,195 girls had been converted to Islam. Yes. There were other datas also.
Yes,
so datas have been submitted. And yet we are trying to be politically correct and we are trying to project that we are secular.
Fact is, why haven't they thought about an anti-conversion law in Kerala? Mufti Ziai, please come in. Rajiv Rai and Shahryar Khan coming across to you after Mufti Ziai. And there are people who are watching the debate and saying recent incidences have shown just how vulnerable we are to all manners of exploitation. These people don't know the real meaning of their religion and hence they get brainwashed easily. Ravi G says, one question, why don't these Islamist persons can live and let live happily together? Damodaran from Vellore says, all secular forces will say they are willingly converted and they love to go to Syria for further studies. Mufti Ziai.
सबसे पहली बात ये हो जाती है कि संबित पत्रा आपकी सारी बातें हमने सुना और दुनिया ने भी सुन लिया. कंडीशंस हमारी क्या बनी हुई है, हालात की कशीदगी क्या बता रही है
आपको और हमें, हिंदुस्तान में अगर इस तरीके की कोई घटना होती है तो यकीनन हिंदुस्तान के तमाम लोग इसका खंडन करते हैं और हम भी इस चीज़ के लिए यहाँ पर मौजूद हैं कि यकीनन ऐसी कोई घटनाएं हुई हैं तो उसका खंडन होना चाहिए। आईएसआईएस अगर अपने पैर को पसारने की कोशिश कर रही है हिंदुस्तान के अंदर में, तो उसका जिम्मेदार कौन होता है इसे भी देखना होगा। आज से पहले अगर हमने देखने की कोशिश की है तो हमारे सामने बात आती है होम मिनिस्टर की। हमारे होम मिनिस्टर ने बाज़ाब्ता तौर पे कहा कि आईएसआईएस कोई ऐसी टीम नहीं है जो हिंदुस्तान में पैर पसार सके। तो अगर इन तमाम चीज़ों को सुन लीजिए पहले, यकीनन जब ऐसी बातें आपके हमारे होम मिनिस्टर्स कहा करते हैं या हमारे डिफेंस मिनिस्टर कहा करते हैं, तो फिर कहाँ चूक रह जाती है आपसे या हमसे कि हम उन तमाम गतिविधियों पर हमारी निगाह नहीं रह पाती है। इन्वेस्टिगेशन टीम हमारी क्या कर रही होती है? 2009 से ये मामला चल रहा होता है और आज तक ऐसी कंडीशन में चल रहा होता है कि लोग इस तरीके की गतिविधियों में शामिल हो रहे हैं, सीरिया जा रहे हैं, आ रहे हैं और ऐसी गतिविधियों में शामिल होकर के अपने आप को एक्सपोज भी कर रहे हैं और दुनिया के सामने भी ला रहे हैं। तो आपकी टीम या हमारी टीम या इन्वेस्टिगेशन कंपनियां ये इन तमाम चीज़ों पर क्या कर रही थी अब तक? और होम मिनिस्टर ने बार बार इस बात को दोहराया है कि आईएसआईएस हिंदुस्तान में पनप नहीं सकती या उसका कुछ भी घृंदा यहां पर नहीं है, तो फिर आप होम मिनिस्टर से क्यों बात कर रहे हैं इस बारे में? होम मिनिस्टर से कभी पूछने की कोशिश क्यों नहीं की जब ये गतिविधियां केरला के तमाम जिलों के अंदर में ये बढ़ रहे हैं, या मलप्पुरम में या कालीकोट में या कुल्लूर में, तो फिर हम और आप कर क्या रहे थे? इन्वेस्टिगेशन कंपनियां क्या
बता रहा हूं एक्टिव नहीं थी? कर रहे थे इसका उत्तर दे देता
हूं।
सुनिए, आप बहुत अच्छा बोलते हैं। आपने कहा 2009 से ये केरला में हर जगह बढ़ रहा था, तो हम आप और ये तमाम राजनेता क्या कर रहे थे? हम लोग वर्ल्ड कॉम्पिटिशन ऑफ सेक्युलरिज्म में पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे थे, दौड़ लगी थी कौन जीतेगा, ये वर्ल्ड कप है। सर सुन लीजिए, मैं आपके पीछे बिल्कुल नहीं बोला, आपसे इजाजत लेके बोल रहा हूँ, आपके बीच में बिल्कुल नहीं बोला। एक वर्ल्ड कॉम्पिटिशन चल रहा था, स्पोर्ट्स चल रहा था कि सेक्युलरिज्म की लड़ाई में कौन सबसे आगे निकल जाएगा, और उसी कारण से 2009 से सब राजनेता वहां पर चेपी लगा के बैठे हुए थे कि सच्चाई होते हुए भी वो कुछ बोलेंगे नहीं, क्योंकि वोट कम हो जाएगा ना, वो वोट बैंक जो है अफेक्टेड हो जाएगा। जहां तक होम मिनिस्टर की बात है, मैं आपको बता देता हूं, राजनाथ जी ने बिल्कुल सही कहा। राजनाथ जी ने कहा भारत के मुस्लिमों पर हमें बिल्कुल विश्वास है, गर्व है। हम जानते हैं कि कभी भी इस्लाम जो भारत का है, जो मुसलमान बंधु भारत के हैं, वो आईएसआईएस को यहां पैर पसारने नहीं देंगे, और हम इन्वेस्टिगेट भी करेंगे अगर कोई पैर पसारने देता है। तो आपको क्या लगता है राजनाथ जी को बोलना चाहिए था नहीं 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 मैं किसी पे विश्वास नहीं करता हूँ, सब डर जाओ, पैनिक सिचुएशन क्रिएट कर दो, अरे सबका साथ सबका विकास, मगर जहां पर गड़बड़ी हुई है उसके तरफ भी उंगली ना दिखाएं हम।
मैंने सुन लिया साहब, सुन लीजिए। अब अगली बात यह होती है कि जब संबित पात्रा साहब, हमारे राजनाथ सिंह ने ऐसी बातें सामने रखी हैं, मैं बड़े अदब और एहतराम के साथ कहता हूं कि जब भी चाहे वो जाकिर नायक का मामला उठा हो या कोई ऐसे तंजीमों का जो कि सोशल तरीके से लोगों को परेशान करते हैं या हिंदुस्तान को बदनाम करने की साजिशें रचते हैं, तो हमेशा मुसलमान ने हिंद जितने भी आए हैं आपके सामने और हम लोगों ने हमेशा उस बात का खंडन किया। इस बात के गवाह आप भी हैं और हमारे साथ बैठ करके आपने भी किया और हमने भी किया है, चाहे वो जाकिर नायक हो या ऐसी कोई भी तंजीम हो। लेकिन क्या हम उनके ऊपर पाबंदियां नहीं लगा सकते? जाकिर नायक के अलावा भी वो लोग जो केरला के अंदर में रह रहे हैं, क्या उसके बारे में हमने कभी सोचने की कोशिश नहीं की? 3 साल हो गए साहब, 3 साल से लोग सवाल पूछ रहे हैं। क्या कितने संस्थाओं पर, जितने नाम हमारे भाई आनंद ने जितने नाम गिनाए आपके सामने, किस किस संस्थाओं पर आपने पाबंदी लगाने की बात की पिछले 3 सालों?
पर वही बात है ना, अगर सेंटर कुछ काम कर हरकत करे उससे पहले स्टेट गवर्नमेंट क्या कर रही है, ये सवाल बनता है। I just want to bring in राजीव राय।
पाबंदियां लगाई हैं और पाबंदी लगाते हैं तो आप ही के भाईजान उठ के वहां पर चिल्लाना शुरू कर देते हैं और राहुल गांधी अरविंद केजरीवाल तुरंत JNU चले जाते हैं कि देखिए
ये तो धर्म
व्यवस्था खतरे में आ गया
है। हम JNU नहीं जाना चाहते हैं क्योंकि ये
JNU नहीं, मैंने उदाहरण दिया है,
पार्टी बंदी
और चिंता मत करिए, ये मजबूत सरकार है, देखते जाइए, इन्वेस्टिगेशन होगा, दूध का दूध पानी का पानी होगा और किसी को बख्शा नहीं जाएगा, मगर उस समय हाथ जोड़ के निवेदन है, उस समय
चलाएंगे। लेकिन
नहीं 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 साहब, देखिए आप जैसे मौलाना मैंने बहुत कम देखे हैं जो सच का सामना अच्छी तरह से
करते हैं। संबित पात्रा जी,
हमने वो करते हैं लेकिन हमें पूरे हिंदुस्तानियों के लिए, एज ए कॉमन मैन, एज ए हिंदुस्तानी में बात करना चाहूंगा, कब तक ये राजनेताओं के चक्कर में हमारा हिंदुस्तान बिगड़ता जाएगा और हमारी सिक्योरिटी के साथ
राजनेताओं के चक्कर में नहीं। पहले आप ये एक्सेप्ट करिए, आज एक बहुत आप स्कॉलर हैं, आप ये एक्सेप्ट करिए, यू एक्सेप्ट टुनाइट दैट देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज रेडिकल इस्लामाइजेशन। वी आर नॉट कंडेमिंग इस्लाम, we are talking about radical Islamization and you have to accept until and unless the liberal Muslim sir सुनिए एक बहुत important बात बता रहा हूँ, आप यहीं से शुरू करिए, until unless the liberal Muslim starts condemning all this। आप लोग देखिए, बहुत जो liberal Muslim है जो बहुत चाहते हैं कि ऐसा नहीं हो, वो लोग बोलते नहीं है। आप लोग बोलना शुरू करिए, कंडेम करना शुरू करिए।
देखिए आप, वो तो समित पात्रा जी आपके बताने से हम नहीं बोलेंगे, हम तो सच्चाई का सामना करने वाले लोग हैं और सच्चाई को हम दुनिया के सामने भी पेश करते हैं। लेकिन आपके राजनेताओं के चक्कर में कब तक हिंदुस्तान का कॉमन मुसलमान
सिंपल आपके लिए एक सजेशन है, केरला के एक निवासी संबित पात्रा जी आपको कह रहे हैं, संबित पात्रा जी बीजेपी इन केरला इज वेरी पुअर एंड इनइफेक्टिव, लैक्स गुड लीडर्स, अमित शाह जी प्लीज डू समथिंग अबाउट दिस। बट इन द मीन टाइम मूविंग ऑन, शारियार खान थैंक यू फॉर योर पेशेंस, राजीव राय थैंक यू फॉर योर पेशेंस, जस्ट ब्रिंगिंग यू इन, ब्रिंगिंग यू इन, यस यस शारियार खान,
Can I come in?
Gandhi saab, they have not spoken in 36 minutes. Let me just speak to the two gentlemen and then I'll come back to you, sir. Sorry, Sharia. Yes, go please. Go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Supreme Court has given the charge of investigation to the NII because, you know, Kerala police is partisan.
NIA.
That is far from truth. Dr. Patra should read about the Operation Pigeon, which, you know, the Kerala police had launched 350 vulnerable youths who were inclined to join the ISIS were identified and de-radicalized. This operation was conducted in collaboration with IB and the NIA. You know, to cast aspersions on any police is not a good thing to do. And also, he spoke about radicalization of Islam. I condemn Islamic radicalization in unequivocal terms. It should not happen. And Supreme Court has taken the proper view of, you know, instituting investigation to find out the pattern and the same entities acting to, conspiring to, you know, convert vulnerable Hindu girls and sending them to ISI. That is very bad. It has to be investigated. But what about radicalization of Hindu religion? What about the killings of Pehlu Khans and Junaids? Is there no radicalization of other religions? See, in India, what is happening today is there is radicalization of all religions. No citizen has a business to convert another citizen to his own religion and misuse him against his own nation, or, you know, send him to another nation to
But the fact that remains is, Sharia Khan,
allow me to answer this.
No, but the fact that remains is
today, allow me to answer this. Anand is a very articulate orator, but he should be fed with the truth as well. No. Allow me to answer this, Anand, please. See, as far as your submission that the Hindus also are getting radicalized, very humbly let me
submit, after
sir.
You should allow me to talk to Patra Anand.
Yes,
yeah,
you,
yes,
should,
yes,
ask,
yes,
to counter him. You should allow me to counter him.
Yes.
Well, please let me complete, sir. With great humbleness, I submit. When you said that Hindus also have been radicalized, I'm extremely sorry. There's nothing called as radicalization in Hinduism. See, I will submit these statistics to prove the same. And I do not want to go beyond the borders of this country.
Sir,
I want to stick to the ideology. Let me complete. No, let me just complete.
Sir, there is also, much as I would like to say, Mr. Dr. Patra,
if the Hindus would have been radical,
this 2009 report in Kerala also talks about conversion centers for Hindus in Kozhikode city.
Contrary to the Islamic radicalization that we see in Pakistan, where the Hindus have reduced from 20% to 2%, that shows that Hindus can never be radical. Ek Ram temple ke liye sadiyon se Hindu ladta raha hai. Aur aap kehte hain Hindu radical
hai.
Let us not talk about
Pakistan. There was a Maulvi over here. ISIS and Gaurakshaks are
the issue today. The issue today is forced conversions in Kerala. Hindu girls being fed to the ISIS as fodder, as sex slaves.
Muslim women should be disinterred from their tombs.
The fact is,
what about them?
Fact is. Let's not digress, gentlemen. Shariar Khan, you have a point. Sambit Patra, you have rebutted, but I want to come back to the debate because I have limited time. Rajiv Rai has not spoken in 39 minutes. Rajiv Rai, gentlemen, my point, sir, is there is a brazen operation that is afoot.
There is a brazen operation that is afoot.
Whether it is happening in whichever religion, if it is being done to try and feed girls, impressionable girls, as sex slaves, to feed the depravity in the name of religion, sir, whoever that person is, you have to stand up against that because it's an insult to that religion and to the people of the country. That's my point. Whether it is Islam, whether it is Christianity, whether it is Hinduism, everybody needs to stand up. My point is, sir, the Kerala High Court, and they say that this is rampant since 1996. 1996, people knew about it, that there was a concentrated effort to convert and to change the demography and use people from a different community for the purpose of another community. And then over a period of time since the turn of 2000, towards 2007, 2009, 2010, 11, 12, 13, 14, especially 15, 16, there is an effort, Rajiv Rai, to send these girls in the guise of a pilgrimage, of doing their service to the faith or indoctrination as sex slaves to never return.
Anand,
Anand, it is done by whichever elements, whichever gang, group or religions or radical elements. It is just an, a criminal act and law of land must crush them. Since Supreme Court has taken cognizance of this, NIA is investigating the matter. Let the report come. And we are with the nation, we are with the nation. There cannot be discussion on national security. Let us not bring our petty politics here, our religion here. Whichever religious group or gang is doing this, this is unacceptable. Only thing, let us wait for the...
Whichever religious group? What do you mean by whichever religious group?
No, you want me to speak whatever you want? You want me to speak?
No,
don't
sir,
you
think
any other religion?
This is the unnecessary politics. Sambit Patra,
After Rajiv Rai completes, allow Rajiv Rai to make his point, please. He's patiently listened to all the other panelists. Let's accord him that respect at least, please. Yes, Rajiv.
Please.
You may disagree with him. Please speak.
Anand, my only submission is, I am in total agreement with what you spoke before speaking to me in your opening statement. Whichever elements, whichever gang, whichever religion, if it is happening, it is unacceptable. And I do not call it, you know, love jihad. If you talk in love jihad in a general term, I'm afraid, in the best interest of the nation, I may be wrong, you may not agree with me. But if you talk about the Muslim and Hindu, there is a love jihad, it will create more differences, hatredness among the community, which is not good for the country. I am sure the true Islam, true Muslims also will condemn this kind of act. It is happening. And the Supreme Court judgment, whatever, nobody has right to question Supreme Court wisdom, Supreme Court decision. Whatever judgment comes from Supreme Court, it is the responsibility of the state government as well as the central government to crush this kind of element wherever they may be.
Ratan Sharda.
See, my problem is that when we face anything right in the eyes, we refuse to recognize it. Since 1996, this is happening. This habit of creating victimhood syndrome, trying to equivalence between Hinduism and Islam in terms of terror, where has Hindu gone and bombed anybody? Has it happened in Kashmir where Hindus have been thrown out? Has it happened anywhere in India that has happened? Have Hindus gone out and created terror somewhere? So let us not be create an equivalence. There is a demon there, using Quran and using Islam to create a Wahhabi psychology which is hurting the world, which is hurting India. Let us accept the devil and see to it that doesn't grow. As simple as that. We should not be apologetic. We should not be in denial mode. Unless we do that, we cannot solve the problem. As simple as that.
Yes.
People are laughing at us. When we talked about love jihad, people are ridiculing. People, when Christians complained about it, when Hindus complained about it, now it becomes a reality. So is this the way to treat a problem till it throws in your face? Why can't we recognize that threat when it is seen by everybody in the world or in India itself?
But that's the reality,
in the name
sir.
Of
that's the reality around
the
us.
Culture of this
Ratan
country.
Sharda ji, that's the reality around us.
Even in Kerala.
No, that's the reality around us. As I go back to Sayyid
exactly,
Qadri Sahab and Zafar
Sareeswala.
No, the reality around us is ki jab tak para, jab pani sar se upar nahi chadta, humko nahi dikhta hai. Humko nahi samajh mein aati ki hum doobne wale hain. That's the reality, sir.
Or
when somebody rings the alarm and says, "Dekho, khatra aa raha hai," nobody believes it. Bole, aane do, aaya nahi abhi tak. Pani chada kahan hai? Aap doobne wale abhi doobe kahan hai? That's the reality, sir. That's the reality. Look at this. Had this problem been nipped in 2006, 2007, 2009, when the court said it, when the cop said it?
कोई भी धर्म के धर्म से क्यों ना हो?
नहीं, बिल्कुल. आप बताइए, कादरी साहब, 2009 में DGP कहता है, कोर्ट कहती है, लेकिन कौन क्या करता है? हाथ पे हाथ धरे बैठे हैं. आज देखिए कहां बैठे हैं हम. देखिए 2011 से 2015 के आंकड़े आपको गिना दूं.
देखिए मिस्टर आनंद, मैं आपका जवाब ये दे रहा हूं.
कादरी साहब, ये 2011 से 15 के आंकड़े मैं जैसे मैं आपको गिना रहा हूं, मैं आपको बता रहा हूं.
मैं बता रहा हूं आपको सर, देखिए
जो मेरे पास है मैं वो मैं बता रहा हूं. 11 से 15
नहीं, कन्वर्ट करना ये बिल्कुल गुनाह है. और इस्लाम कभी इस चीज की इजाजत
मैं आपको क्या बोल रहा हूँ, मैं आपसे ये कह रहा हूँ सर, मैं आपसे ये कह रहा हूँ,
आपने अगर नहीं माना तो हिंदुस्तान में तो इस्लाम तलवार के जोर पे कैसे,
मैं आपसे क्या कह रहा हूँ,
जब तस्वीर पेश करते हैं आप, ये गलत हुआ था,
लेट मी टेल यू दैट के भाई कर रहे हैं धर्म कन्वर्ट आप नहीं कर सकते, मगर मिस्टर आनंद दास ये भी आपको देखना पड़ेगा, अगर साल पहले जो घर वापसी के नाम में जो कारनामा हो रहा था, घर वापसी के नाम पर तो क्या ये बाइफोर्स कन्वर्शन नहीं हुआ, मिस्टर आनंद कुछ दिन पहले जो बाइफोर्स ये जो घर वापसी के नाम पर जो कहानी चल रहा था, घर वापसी के नाम पर जो हमारे मुसलमान भाई को हिंदू करवाया जा रहा था, पहले जिसको घर वापसी के नाम पर जोर जबरदस्ती करके ये हिंदुइज्म के मुताबिक ठीक है,
आपको एक बात बताओ,
इस्लाम इजाजत नहीं देता,
नहीं मैं आपको कह रहा हूँ, देखिए यहाँ पर न्यूज आर में सीना, देखिए मैं एक बात बताऊँ आप लोग, आपको ये आंकड़े पता नहीं थे या आपने गौर ही नहीं फरमाया, 5723 कन्वर्जन हुए हैं बिटवीन 2011 to 2015, ये इंटेलिजेंस रिपोर्ट कहती है। अब उसमें से एक बात बताओ आपको, 60% ऑफ दीज वुमेन, 60% of these conversions were women. Total this number, देखिए 2006 से 12 7713, 2011 से 15 तक के बीच में जो नंबर है ये Christians that got converted to Islam 2600. Let's just move forward, 5723 93, yeah, that's this number. 2011 to now, इसमें से देखिए 60%
ठीक है, मैंने
were women,
देख लिया,
women,
देख लिया,
women, and
मैंने देख लिया आनंद,
and 76% of them were less than 35 years. मैं आपसे ये बात पूछ रहा हूं कि जब ये हो रहा था and people were saying कि this is forced, किसने आवाज उठाई, किसने कुछ
देखिए आनंद इस बात को वजाहत के साथ कर दूं कि हम तो ये समझ रहे हैं कि हमारी हिंदू बहनों को यकीनन उसको कमतर समझा जा रहा है, उनके जहन को बहुत छोटा समझा जा रहा है कि मुसलमान बच्चे जाकर के उसको अपनी तरफ खींच लेते हैं, क्या वो कमजोर है हमारी बहन,
आप उन सारी फैमिलीज के खिलाफ क्यों खड़े हो गए जो वापस हिंदू धर्म को अपनाना चाहते थे, तब घर वापसी पर इतना बवाल क्यों हुआ, जब 300 फैमिलीज एक साथ आ रही थी वापस, तब घर वापसी का बवाल क्यों हुआ मुझे बताइए,
इसलिए हुआ
नहीं, तब घर वापसी का, तब वो जबरदस्ती है, तब वो 300
की लालच,
किसने दिया पैसे की लालच, किसने दिया पैसे की लालच, किसने दिया, आपके पास कोई प्रूफ है पैसे की लालच, वहां पैसे की लालच हो गई, यहाँ कोई लालच नहीं, यहाँ बेवकूफ नहीं बनाया उनको, यहाँ उनको झूठ नहीं बोला गया, यहाँ उनको 3 महीने बंद क्यों करके रखा गया,
कमजोर साबित,
आप एक बात बताइए, कोई अगर इस्लाम को समझना चाहता है तो क्या उसको आप 3 महीने बंद, क्या उसको आप 3 महीने एक सेंटर के अंदर बंद करेंगे,
बिल्कुल
क्या उसको ब्रेन वॉश करेंगे, तो अगर ये हुआ है इन सबके साथ ऐसा हुआ,
सबके साथ ऐसा,
इनके साथ ऐसा हुआ, ये सत्य सरणी सेंटर को आप को बंद कर देना चाहिए, आपने क्यों नहीं बंद किया,
35 साल बता
आपने, आपने नहीं, मैंने बोला 35 साल से कम थी उनकी उम्र,
तो क्या 35 साल,
जफर सरेश वाला,
क्या समझदार,
जफर सरेश वाला, जफर सरेश वाला
पढ़ी लिखी नहीं,
नहीं ऐसा
उन सबको
एक बाप, नहीं एक बाप, अगर जबरन नहीं होना चाहिए तो इनको इस क्लिनिक में किस बहाने से 3 महीने बंद करके रखा गया, मोबाइल ले लिया गया, सिम कार्ड ले लिया गया, घर वालों से बात करने नहीं दिया, और
क्या करें,
अरे और उनको कोर्ट में ये सिखा के पढ़ा के, ये पढ़ा के गया है,
अच्छा
जब कोर्ट के पास गए पता है क्या कहा गया उनको, अपने माँ बाप से मिलोगे तो वो तुमको खींच लेंगे, गलती से भी उनसे मिलना मत, ऐसी बात, अगर उनको सिखा पढ़ा के क्यों भेजा गया,
पढ़ी लिखी बच्ची,
अगर उनको सिखा पढ़ा के क्यों, तो एक बात बताइए, आज के बाद किसी और कोई अगर इस्लाम को छोड़ के किसी दूसरे धर्म को अपनाता है तो कभी आप ये नहीं कहेंगे कि उनको इंड्यूसमेंट दिया गया,
अरे साहब
क्यों, वो भी तो समझदार है, वो बेवकूफ है कि उनको पैसे का लालच दे दिया वो ले लेंगे, जफर सरेश वाला,
आनंद
जफर सरेश वाला,
आनंद
जी,
या आनंद आनंद आनंद, द इश्यू इज टिल वी डोंट एक्सेप्ट दैट देर इज सम फॉल्ट वी विल नेवर रिमूव दैट, सो इफ देर इज अ फॉल्ट लाइन वी हैव टू वर्क टूवर्ड्स इट, एंड आई वॉन्ट टू रिमाइंड यू दैट देर इज लार्ज नंबर ऑफ मुस्लिम्स, द क्लेरिक्स, द प्रोग्रेसिव मुस्लिम्स हु आर वर्किंग टूवर्ड्स डी रेडिकलाइजेशन, एंड आई एम ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ दैट ग्रुप which has been, we even went to the jails. We talked to people who were there on terror charges. And our effort has worked. And 90% of the people who had some idea, some wrong idea, some wrong notion, when we put across the right thing, then they understood. Mm. So if radicalization is happening, it is our duty to work towards de-radicalization.
Bilkul sahi, sir.
And that is the duty of the Maulana sitting there, myself, and lot of people like us. We need to do that.
I agree with you, sir, but I think all of you need to take the first flight out to Kerala, especially North Kerala, and figure out what's going out on ground there. I seriously say that, sir, and I'm not making any bones about it, because this needs to be done, because what's happening in Kerala is dangerous. There is a Gaza street where the cops don't dare to enter. That's the reality. इस लेवल तक है कि एक बेटी अपने बाप को कह रही है इस कॉन्वर्जेशन में, आप डर क्यों रहे हो, आपको डर लगता है तो आप पुलिस के साथ आ जाओ, मल्लापुरम में हमारे सेंटर में आप पुलिस के साथ आ जाओ, तब आपको कुछ नहीं होगा. संबित पात्रा, फाइनल वर्ड सर, आई हैव टू वाइंड अप, वे ओवर टाइम.
See, in fact, as Mr. Rathan Sarda rightly suggested, that we should not try to trivialize and generalize the whole issue by equating Islam, Hindus, Christians in every take of ours. We should face the problem with all kind of courage over here. Secondly, and extremely importantly, the Maulana Ji was saying that, well, look, these girls, Hindu girls, should not be demeaned. Their intelligence should not be demeaned. If they want to marry someone, we should not call it radicalization. Now, let me tell you, indoctrination is something which has in the past done the kind of sin which is unimaginable. Remember, in 9/11 bomb attacks, most of these aeroplanes that were hijacked by were well-educated young men. I mean, someone was a doctor, someone was an engineer. So if these people can be indoctrinated to an extent, that they could bomb.
देखिए,
क्या बोल रहे हैं उड़ीसा में?
उड़ीसा में क्या अपना है? कितनी कितनी क्रिश्चियन बहनों को आपने कन्वर्ट करवाया हिंदुओं में?
नहीं,
हमने
देखा उसको.
देखिए, मैं एक बात बताऊं,
ऐसा कोई कन्वर्ट हो रहा है?
अगर अगर कहीं पर भी कोई भी कन्वर्सन अगर फोर्स्ड है तो गलत है. मैं इस बात को जैसे आप कह रहे हैं,
हम जानते हैं
जो आप कह रहे हैं. देखिए, मैं एक बात बताऊं सर, जो प्रत्यक्ष है उसको प्रमाण की क्या जरूरत? ये सामने हमने दिखा दिया. एज वी वाइंड अप, दीज आर द बिग क्वेश्चंस ऑन द न्यूज़ आर टुनाइट. इजंट देयर इनफ एविडेंस दैट देयर इज अ पैटर्न to these conversions in Kerala? Why shouldn't it be addressed with alacrity right now? Despite the Love Jihad angle highlighted by the Kerala High Court since 2009, why hasn't the state acted? Governments have changed, no action has happened. With more than 60% of the 5,793 conversions between 2011-2015 being women, isn't the plot clear? Next question. What with more than 3 victims claiming that they were to be sent to ISIS bases, doesn't the sex slave theory take root? With many states enacting an anti-forced conversion law, why hasn't Kerala moved to enact the same? In fact, there is Rajasthan, there is Arunachal Pradesh where it's still pending. Other states have enacted it. Isn't it evident that radical organizations with connections to terror outfits are brazenly targeting Hindu girls? Can the state and authorities dismiss the real threat that these organizations pose to the security of this country? Because tomorrow you never know who's going to come out and do what act. And then you see the damage that it will cause. And isn't this depravity being practiced in the name of Islam and bringing the religion a bad name? And that's why you see individuals from the community who are here on the News Hour condemn this act outright. Thank you very much for joining us on the News Hour tonight.